And there is more to this case because it involves the church and also leaders. To get perspective on that, our Tim Cherno talked to Dr. Charles Reed. He's a professor of law from the University of St. Thomas. Tim?
Well, this is an extraordinary case, and at this point, every step is a big step. Listen to Dr. Charles Reed's reaction to today's court ruling.
I was surprised. I was surprised with the swiftness with which this happened, and I think this is a very stunning and important development.
Okay, Reed says court-compelled testimony reaching to this level of church hierarchy is uncommon. He says this usually doesn't happen. When Archbishop Neinstedt and former Vicar General Kevin McDonough leave the church and enter the courtroom, the two men enter as private citizens in civil court.
Testifying under oath is a big deal. You are now bound to tell the truth, and you're bound by the rules governing perjury if you don't.
Testimony in both matters will be sealed. That means only court officials and attorneys will have access to what is said. But Reed says that privacy is not a win for the church.
That does not give the Archbishop or Father McDonough any additional freedom, because their testimony is still subject to perjury charges if they dissemble or dissimulate under oath. But what it does do is protect the victim.
And what plaintiff's attorneys will want from Neinstedt and McDonough is information on, is there or isn't there, has there been or has there never been a plan? Get used to hearing the words procedures and policies.
Are there systematic flaws in the Archdiocese? Are there systematic flaws, weaknesses, the way these cases have been handled?
Reed says there is always the potential for something in a case like this to rupture, to basically burst wide open. But that's something we don't know. And unless the content of the testimony becomes public, we may never know. However, he says if other people come forward with allegations, that will keep the pressure on.
No doubt. Thanks, Tim. And right now on our website, we have lists of accused priests that have already been published. Plus, you can watch our previous coverage. Go to KSTP.com and click on links.